Okay. Citizens of Chichester, I, Richard Plowman, town crier of Chichester, and also town crier of the ancient corporation of St. Pancras, and therefore known throughout the land as Richard Twobills, do hereby welcome the Murray family to Chichester. And I also summons you to a meeting with the Right Worshipful Mayor of Chichester, Councillor Peter Budge. So, I'm also authorised to appoint today one deputy and three assistants to help me in my duties. You have the little bell? Right, okay. My three assistants, please step forward. Oop, here we are. And one for you, there we are. Okay.
Oh,
I hereby appoint you as deputy and assistant to the town crier of Chichester. Thank you. And finally, God save the Queen! So, deputy, assistants, is everybody in line?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Let's go. Oh, yay! Oh, yay! Please make way for the Murray family. Make way for the Murray family, direct descendants of Admiral Sir George Murray. Thank you. Please turn to left.
My grandson, Christian.
Oh, hello, I like your hat too.
Nice to meet you, Mayor.
Yes, my deputy for today. So.
Right. Hello, Aaron. Nice to see you. I'm sorry, I won't remember all your names, but I'll try. Okay.
Can we sit down? Is that
yes.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Come on,
yeah.
There's enough chairs.
Enough room.
We'll have to settle up.
He would have used these chairs. So you may well be sitting on a chair which Admiral Sir George sat on.
Wow, look at that.
Oh, there we are. That's good, isn't it?
Now, as you know, we do have lady mayors as well. Of course, Anne was mayor three times. And the problem that we also have that's lovely, is the mayor comes in different sizes.
Got the right coloured dress on.
Yes, it is lovely. That's very nice. I think it's probably our most glamorous.
All the family now.
Okay, and let's have the hat. You are very important. Oh, so I need a slightly bigger one, I think. Oh, no, we're all right.
Yeah. All right.
Well,
that's
right.
Yeah.
Well done.
This is where we do all our work, where we sit down and decide on the fate of people and the city. And we had a big meeting last night in here that went on until about 9 o'clock. We were here from half past four to 9 o'clock, nearly 5 hours.
John, 1689.
Up to when was this royalist Chichester?
Oh, well, Chichester stood out for the king for 6 days under siege.
Mm-hmm.
Probably because of the cathedral. It was a religious war, basically, wasn't it? So that the royalists were the religious people, the parliamentarians were the Puritans, and therefore there was a sort of difference of opinion over which way we should worship.
George Murray's wife, and there she is, a forward old lady.
And I believe Murray and Richard Murray each paid £200, as did John Marsh, £200 towards the building of this building. And so you would have here the clerk at the bottom. You would have the reader, and at the top, who could see everybody upstairs and downstairs, and could also see the clock. And he was the preacher. The university had the quality.
or usually quite a long time, for their chamber orchestra.
The organ is there, but it's all in pieces. And it was the organ that was played by John Marsh.
What are we trying to do? We're trying to encourage the Moss family to put that into a museum. Because it's
currently their property and their
at the moment it's the Moss family, yes. So Richard
has made the links with them, and it was really as a result of doing the talk here in the record office that they came and joined the audience and brought along some of the artifacts with them. And so this was the actual sword that he had when that's Robert James Moss as captain of the Monarch. And that was the sword he actually had at the battle.
Wow.
And that's also the telescope he would have used at the battle as well. So they're both genuine parts. And then the map here, which is very unusual, shows the Battle of Copenhagen, where your ancestor was very, very important. So Captain Murray, as he was then, soon to become Admiral Murray, in the Edgar, led the van, as it's called, that's ships, into the battle.
His problem,
and he
his
looks at it from
the
Danish side, which is always quite
interesting.
Well, it was my first intended that you should be captain of the victory. Then it was thought better
unless
you should go out with me.
And he died 1800.
So that, he died in 1805.
Five.
Was no case by coach. Does it say the ships of names of the ships of the
yes, they're here. Here's the Defiance, Monarch.
The ability to have a complete crossfire.
Yeah.
Absolutely murderous.
They had a celebration 200 years of the Battle of Copenhagen, actually in Copenhagen. It was interesting because there's a very good little book
relationship
on the Monarch.
Right.
Lord,
it's
not
meant to do.
Right.
He was a very good friend of mine. And what about your next?
We've looked around the museum, and because it's such a significant exhibition for us, we wanted to dedicate its own space. So rather than mix it in with the other galleries, we wanted to have its own clear space. So this is the area that we've decided on. So this entire area, if you just imagine it as a blank space, and then this will become totally the Murray exhibition here. So the centrepiece will be the sword and the other items, such as the tray. But we have a brand new case coming, a very high spec case coming for the centrepiece.
Here at the end of the month,
yeah. We will board over all of these boards here, and we'll also possibly bring a large case in for further objects that we'll be getting from the Naval Museum in Portsmouth, and also possibly from the Scilly Isles. I think that was still coming along. So this whole gallery area will be dedicated to the exhibition. Some of the orders and some of the letters can be blown up on the walls, so people will be able to have better accessibility to them. We were looking here possibly having a DVD and a seat with headphones so people can sit down and watch the film.
And the tray will come over. What will happen is that we'll see the case upstairs, and it's about this big.
Right.
So the tray is here already, and also the dispatch box.
Right.
And they'll go into the one big case.
Right.
This will then go back to Hunt House, who lent it to us, and they'll have their own special case. And it's a very nice case.
It's a lovely case.
You'll see from the one on the right and land. Okay.
And it was Dean Walter Hook who had the unenviable task of raising the funds to rebuild the spire, and it was rebuilt in 5 years by Sir George Gilbert Scott. I discovered that was the font that was here.
Goodness.
And when the new church had been built, the congregation moved across the road and the font went over there with it. And then just not that many years ago, maybe 20 years ago, that church was amalgamated with St. Paul's Church, another Victorian church, and the font moved. And this is the font that once stood here. And I would be almost certain that this is the font in which Admiral Sir George Murray, as would be, was baptized. But isn't that a nice font? Yeah. And this is where Admiral Sir George Murray and his wife are both buried in paradise here. Yeah. It's rather a nice place, isn't it?